Welcome to Six Sigma Mania. Risk assessment is a great tool to understand hazard size. It helps us understand where to implement preventive actions. It can be safety, quality, finances, project management, and other areas where this assessment can help us understand any risks. We must define risk first. Hazard or risk does not mean danger that some incident happens. It is a combination of incident probability and severity of incident consequences. Hazard, thus, is not a workspace, machine or process itself, but the likelihood that something wrong occurs in some period of time. Example: when we drive a car, danger is not a car itself, but possibility that we fail to notice other cars while entering the main road. Here are three steps to proceed with risk assessment. Risk source identification. Risk seriousness evaluation. The risk matrix. And countermeasurements introduction. If not to full risk elimination, so at least to risk reduction. Make sure you follow these advices during risk source identification. The best way to start is to identify one process or concrete situation to be assessed. Do not solve whole facility at once. To identify process to be assessed, use process mapping. Plan this activity in advance. People must count with it in their schedule. Work as a team. Invite at least one person from assessed process, as well as colleagues from different departments. Visit and observe assessed process. Walk to see is key to reveal hazards. Do not hesitate to ask questions while observing. Note each hazard on paper or directly to computer under each other and create table. There are two criteria in risk seriousness evaluation, as already mentioned: incident probability and consequences severity. Each criteria have five categories. Probability categories are: randomly to happen, unlikely to happen, probably to happen, very probably to happen, permanently to happen. And consequences severity categories are: very low, low, medium, high, very high. Match each identified risks with probability and severity number. Now, there are more options how to identify risk seriousness. You can multiply probability and severity numbers. Higher calculated number, higher risk seriousness. Advantage of this approach is that you can have countermeasures listed next to each risk. For better risk seriousness visualization, use risk matrix. There are two axes on the matrix, one representing probability and second severity. There are three sections matrix is divided in: low risk seriousness, the green one, middle, orange one, and high risk seriousness, marked red. Enter matched risks numbers to each axis and find meeting point. Seriousness level is now obvious and visual. You can use percentage numbers for more precise seriousness definition if required. I suggest using combination of both methods to visualize and address risk with countermeasures. Find the right balance between countermeasure and its price. Review hazard rates after taking measures against reviewed processes. Numbers should go down under tolerable limit. If not, review what else you can implement to improve it. Take a look under the video, where you find a link to my blog. You can download seriousness table and risk matrix templates for free. If you find this video helpful, give us a like. Hit the subscribe button and join Sigma Maniacs. Do not hesitate to post your comments, questions, or themes you are interested in to see on this channel. Have a great day.